There we go. We'll see the second table here, and we need to add it to the metadata so that the API knows about it. So let's track that table. So now you can actually see there's the identifier and the address, and there is no primary key, as you can see. So now this table is available for me to insert data to as I need to without having a forced identifier there. So like if there's a table that has redundancies or something like that and something that might be a key, or just something that doesn't have particular key data but you need to get it into a table, this is the way to go about doing that. All right, so the next thing I want to do though is, even though we added that to the metadata, I also want to take it back out of the metadata just for this example. So I'm going to bounce back here. We're going to kill the running console for the moment. And then get in here and let's check out the metadata. Let's go into databases. Here's the default. And here's the YAML around first table, second table, right? So here's second table. And then tables is listed here. Let's take it out of here, and let's delete this. And I believe that's what I got to do. Let's check. We got tables. Yeah. All right. Then save this one. And now I'm going to do Hasura metadata apply. And then we want to relaunch the console again to go check out our change. And let's see what we got. Back to data. There's our first table. If we click on public, there's the second table out of metadata. So it's not in the metadata section anymore. And that is technically what I wanted to achieve. So if you ever add a table to the databases list into the metadata, you can go into the metadata itself, remove it, and then just reapply that metadata with Hasura metadata and apply. That'll knock the table back out. It'll just show as an untracked table. And you can do that with the other things too, like with the foreign key relationships, custom functions, etc. But do be careful in metadata. You might tweak something that then misreads or whatnot. But everything is in those files for the metadata for the API server. So if there's anything that you don't actually want in there, then you can just delete it from those files and reapply it via Hasura metadata apply, and boom, everything's cleaned up.